Digital workflows are most effective when they are seamlessly integrated in the day-to-day life of your users. And where are users active every day? Exactly, in Microsoft Teams. So that's why it makes perfectly sense that your SharePoint solutions are directly integrated into Microsoft Teams. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step how this works easily so that your users can find all information and processes they need where they are. No jumping between different tools. Let's dive in and make your SharePoint solutions really user-friendly. Due to digitizations, more and more tools are used by your end users. Most of the tools are island solutions, which means they don't integrate with other tools and are not integrated into the existing environment of your company. That's not the case with the SharePoint solutions. They are perfectly integrated in the M365 suite, which also means they are integrated into Microsoft Teams. The more tools you have, the more island solutions your users use, the more chaos arises. It perfectly makes sense to integrate as many workflows as possible into the existing environment, which is M365. The first question which arises when you want to integrate your SharePoint solution into Microsoft Teams is where to do that. You can do that in the Teams of Microsoft Teams. Choose a team which already exists, where all people who should use the solution have access to. Try to choose a team which you can also use for communication within the workflow. So everything which is related to the solution is in one place. If there isn't an existing team you can use, create a new one. But only create a new one if there isn't an existing one, because the more teams you have, the more chaos arises. Is there anything you should think of when creating a SharePoint solution which later on needs to be integrated into Microsoft Teams? Yes, there are a few points. First one is there is no going back button. In your browser, you always have a going back button, so that's something you don't need to take into account when creating a SharePoint solution. If you want to integrate it into Microsoft Teams, you need to provide a going back button. So otherwise, your users won't have the chance to go a step back. Another thing which you should think about is that the side and top navigation isn't available in Microsoft Teams. So the typical SharePoint layout is not in Microsoft Teams. You only have your solution. If you need any navigation in your solution, you need to build it on your pages, in your lists, wherever you want to have it. In order to integrate the SharePoint solution into Microsoft Teams, you at first need to copy the URL. Then go to the team where you want to integrate your SharePoint solution, click on the plus, select SharePoint, choose the radio button, which is the second one, and insert the copied URL. Go on save, and as you can see, now the social media post planner, which we first had in our browser, is now directly integrated into Microsoft Teams. You can do every action you want to. You see the same interface as online. So for example, you can open a form, which works the same as if you would have done that in the online mode. You can go on pages, so you can use the full solution as you just would have done online in your browser. That's it! A simple way to integrate your SharePoint solutions into Microsoft Teams, which will make life of your end users a lot easier. If you want to learn more about smart SharePoint solutions, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions, just drop a comment below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.